Hi everyone, we are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session, and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.
Hello, everyone. So how is everyone doing today? Great. I hope everybody is doing fine, right? Everybody is staying at home and keeping and washing themselves clean, right? Very good, very good. So is everybody excited about today's class? Any idea what today's class is going to be about? Correct, correct. So today's class is going to be based on theme of autumn. So we will be making a fan folded leaf. Yes, wall hanging, correct. Fan folded leaf, wall hanging. So everybody just get ready with all of your equipments. Everybody get ready with the equipments. Right? Everybody excited? Yes, so by the end of the class, you will have a nice wall decoration based on the theme of autumn that you will be able to use. Correct. All right, we will start off with the list of materials that we will need for today's class. So is everybody able to see my screen? Everybody is able to see my screen, right? So like for every class, like I say, always have some sort of a board or any newspaper or any sheet, any spare sheet spread over the floor so that it doesn't destroy or doesn't ruin the surface on which you're going to paint. All right, so here I have a board. And what are the other materials that we need? So we will need a piece of paper, our branch, our piece of string or thread. We will need a pencil, our eraser, and our sets of brushes. All right, and also you will need your acrylic colors. And if you're using acrylic colors, you would also need a piece of jar of water. Correct. Very good. Everybody knows about it. Fine. All right. Everybody ready? Everybody just take the piece of paper that you have to make your leaves. Correct. Everybody just get ready with it. Everybody just get ready with the piece of paper. Shall we start off? Shall we begin? So first we will make four folds out of this piece of paper. All right, just see how we will make the four folds. So just one fold like this, press it down, and one more fold like this. Nicely press it down. All right, just get it done till this step. We have just made two folds of the paper lengthwise. All right, lengthwise first fold, lengthwise another fold, second fold. Two folds of the paper. Just everybody fold the papers like this. Everybody just get the papers folded like this. All right. Okay. Those of you who are finished with this, you can take out your pencil and your eraser. We will be drawing the leaves now on this piece of paper that we have folded. Okay. First fold the paper into two, once fold, and then second fold on top of it. And then take out your pencil and eraser. We will be drawing the leaves on top of it. Okay. So we will draw two sets of leaves. One leaf will be a bit larger in size and the next leaf will be a bit smaller in size. So two sets of leaves we will be getting out of this folded piece of paper. So everybody ready? We will start off with the drawing of the leaves. Just see, this is my first leaf that I am drawing. This is my large leaf. All right. The first leaf, and on top of it, I will draw another second smaller leaf. Okay, everybody getting it till this? One large leaf and one small leaf you have to draw on that paper that you have just folded. All right, quickly let it be drawn, everyone. Drawing a leaf is very easy, right? Just two arc like shapes like this, that's all. That's all, nothing too difficult. One should be a bigger leaf in size and one should be a smaller leaf in size. All right? Yes. Just get it drawn, everyone, quick. And if somebody has finished drawing, you can get ready with the pair of scissors. All right, we will be cutting out these leaves so that we get four cutouts. Because you've folded your paper two times, that is why you will be getting four sets of papers. Quickly let it be drawn, everyone. Just give me a thumbs up as soon as you're finished. Yes. Very good. All right. So everyone, now take your scissors and we will quickly cut off these pieces. All right, quickly cut off these pieces of leaves from the paper. Be careful. You can take the help of an adult also while you're cutting out these. If you face any issues while cutting them out, you can take the help of an adult also. Nicely cut it out. Just cut along the line that you have drawn. All right. You can see here you have four pieces. Similarly, the smaller one also. Just nicely cut along the edge of the line that you have drawn. Take your time, nicely cut it off. If it's too difficult for you, if your paper layers are getting very thick, you can take the help of an adult also while you are cutting it off. Okay, so at the end, you should have like this, four sets of large leaves and four sets of small leaves like this. Everybody quickly cut off your leaves. Quickly cut the leaf pieces out of your paper. We will just wait for everyone to complete this step. No hurries. Take your time and nicely cut off these leaf pieces. All right, four leaves you should be getting that are large in size and there should be four smaller leaves. Correct. Very good. It's nicely being done. Very nice. Very good. We will wait for everyone. There's nothing to worry about. Just take the help of your adult or anyone, if you are not able to cut it properly, take somebody's help and get all the leaves cut. All right? Okay. So once the leaves are cut, we will move into the coloring portion. We will have to color all of these leaves. So what are the colors that you're going to be using for this? All right, what colors will you be using? Any idea? What are the fall colors? So one color that I've taken out is orange, right? What are the other colors? Your other colors are yellow and red. And also along with that, you can use green also if you have green. Getting it, everyone? So what are the fall colors that you're going to be using? Your red, yellow, orange and green. If you don't have green, there's not an issue. You can just use these three colors only. Your yellow, green and orange. That is your yellow, red and orange. In case you don't have any of these colors, you can use green also. That is also allowed. So these are the colors that are used for fall. Fall is the autumn season. During this season, the leaves, they fall off from the trees. They cover all of your surfaces, the parks, the roads, streets and everywhere. And these are the colors that are associated with this particular season. So everybody, just take out your thick brush and just take out a jar of water, which you will be using to dip your brush into. And we will quickly color off all of these leaves. Okay, just keep alternating. You can make one leaf yellow, one orange, one red leaf, one green leaf, okay? But not anything apart from these colors. Even brown is allowed, but try to keep it within these five colors only. You should not be using any other color. All right? So we will move on with the coloring. So for my first leaf, I will be using the yellow color. So I will just dip my brush into the yellow color and I will straight away start off with coloring my leaf. Just see. Just nicely cover all of the leaf. Nicely color the leaf. Okay. I have taken one small leaf and I'm coloring it first. Your fingers will be getting a bit dirty because you will be touching the leaf, but that doesn't matter. You can wash off your fingers after the class. All right. So like this, you have to cover up the leaf nicely. Once your leaf is done, just leave it out to dry. I will take another leaf. Okay, I will cover it with yellow color also. You can keep trying. You can keep alternating between colors. If you are making one red, one yellow, one orange leaf, you can do that. Otherwise, you can finish off with maybe say two or three yellow leaves and then go for orange color. Anything. Anything is fine. All right. Just that all of the colors should be used. All of these five colors that I have mentioned, they can be used. I will be using only three colors. I will be using your red, orange and yellow. Even green is allowed, brown is allowed. No worries. Okay, so I'm planning on making three yellow leaves. So I've taken one large yellow leaf and two small yellow leaves and I have covered them with yellow color. Nicely cover it up with yellow color. Once you have covered up any leaf, just leave it out to dry. The color needs to dry out before we move to the further processes. So just leave it out to dry a bit. Okay. So my yellow portion is complete. Next, I will now move on to orange. Next, I will make some orange leaves. All right. So here I will dip my brush again in the orange color and let me take some leaves. Let me take a nice large leaf and I will cover it with orange color. So like this, you have to keep changing colors. And out of the five colors that I mentioned, you can use them and you can create leaves like this. Just color them up nicely. Cover them with the color. All right. Any color medium is allowed. You can use acrylic, watercolors, whatever. Even crayons, if you have, you can use them also. There's nothing to worry. All right. It just needs to be looking nice and bright. So here I finished one orange leaf. I will take one smaller leaf also. So like this, get all of the leaves colored. Okay, everybody getting it? So those who have completed orange leaves, you can move on to red leaves. I will also be moving on to red leaves now. Okay, so here is my red color. And now I will be making a red leaf. The same thing. It doesn't need to be two orange leaves only. You can make three if you want, completely up to you. Just that, use these colors only. Okay, and keep changing between these colors. Just don't use one color and color all of the leaves. Keep changing the colors, but your color should be within those five colors only that I have mentioned. Nicely cover up the leaves with the color. All right, so here I have one red leaf. I will cover one more large leaf also with the red color. Everybody can start showing me their work, how they are coloring their leaves, so that I can know that you're following all the instructions properly. All right, they are very, very simple instructions. You have drawn the leaf till now on the paper and you have cut out the leaves from the paper and now you're simply painting them. That's all. Getting it? And this is the last leaf that I will be painting. Just nicely apply color. Your color should be applied properly on all of the leaves. All right? Nicely apply the color on all of the leaves. Very good, very good. Okay, so like this, you should be getting done with all of your leaves. Just wash off your brush and just close the lids of your bottles once you're done. All right. So you should be having leaves like this. All of your leaves should be done before we move on to the next process. Just have all of the leaves ready, everybody. All right. We will wait for everyone to catch up. There's nothing to worry. We will wait for everybody to catch up. All right. No issues, right? So we painted, we took our different colors out of the autumn bracket. What are the colors? Again, I will tell you, they are yellow, red, orange, green, and brown. These are the five only colors that are allowed for this. All right. So if you don't have either of red or orange, you can go for green and brown also. Okay. But out of these five colors, you should not be using any other color apart from these five colors. Okay. Only within these five colors, your work should be done. Correct. Yes. All right. Shall we move on? So everybody knows how to fan fold. Have you ever made a paper fan fold? If not, you can just see the process. Okay. Be very carefully observant about the process. Just see how we are fan folding. And you can replicate the same. So this is the first leaf. Okay. This is the first leaf. One step down like this. Just fold the leaf one step down. All right. Then same on the other side. Down like this. Then again keep changing it. One step down like this. Just keep changing the side and keep folding the leaf like this. All right, again the same. And the last part. So once you fold it, when you spread your leaf out, you will get a fan folded leaf like this. It looks like a 3D leaf. Everybody got it? I will repeat the step again on every leaf. In case you are not able to follow it, it will be repeated multiple times. So try to get it from that. All right, let us take one more leaf here. So first I am folding down one end. Okay, change the end, again fold it, again change and fold. Change and fold. Change and fold and done. Okay. One more time. One more leaf here. Fold. First is fold. Then change side and fold. Again change, fold. Change, fold. Again change and fold. So this is the process. I hope everybody is able to get it. This is very simple. So for all of these leaves, we'll be making the same. So just get it done with all of the leaves like this. I am repeating the process again and again. I'm keeping it near to you so that you can see it. I'm keeping it zoomed up, right? So that you are able to see all of the processes. You can start with any side. You can start by folding any side. Doesn't matter whichever side you folded. All right, doesn't need to be folded on the colored side only. You can start off with folding of any side. So like this, you will end up getting some 3D fan folded leaves. One more here. There you go. One more here. And here. So there you got your leaf. Just two more leaves to go. We will do the same process on them. I hope everybody is getting it. I am repeating the process again and again. In a total of 8 times, the process is being repeated. So I hope everybody should be able to follow it. We are simply fan folding. Simply fan folding the leaf. That's all. Okay. And for the last leaf also. All right. Everybody just get all of your fan folded leaves ready. Just get all the fan folded leaves ready, everyone. It should be ready till this point. Everybody just get it done. Get it done up to this point. Very, very simple. So we have just cut out the leaves. We have drawn the leaves on the paper fold. We have cut out the leaves. We have colored them in the fall colors. And then we have just fan folded it. We have just fan folded it. Yes. Everybody got it. Very good. I can see most of you have no trouble at all following the instructions. You can see we have just fan folded the paper, that is the leaves. That's all. That is how we have ended up with all of these fan folded leaves. Okay, everybody just get it ready. We'll wait for everyone to catch up. Those of you who have finished, you can keep the leaf aside and take out your branch and the wool or ribbon or thread or rope, whatever you're using, or lace, whatever you have at your disposal, you can use that. All right. Okay. We'll wait for some 30 seconds more. Let everybody catch up. shouldn't be having any issues with this, right? Okay. All right, now we will move on to the branch portion. Everybody just get ready with the branches. Okay, just get ready with the branches, everyone, and get ready with your thread or with the wool or ribbon or rope or lace. These are the various things that can be used for this particular craft. You can use whichever one you want. Okay, so we will be making four sets of strings, four sets of hangings. So just take the thread. Okay, take the thread at one end and nicely make a knot. Just make a knot like this. If you are using a very thin thread like mine, you can make multiple knots. Make two or three knots so that it can stay nice and secure. If you are using wool or jute, or if you are using ribbon, at least one knot is enough. Even one knot is enough. Okay. Once you've made a knot, just cut off any extra portions and your length of the string should be somewhat this much. Okay. So like this, we have to make four knots in total. Just make four knots like this. Just make four knots like this and all the extra knotted portion, just cut it out. And just cut out a piece of the string. This extra knot portion I will cut out and I will leave some length of the string like this for the hanging. Four sets of knots like this you will have to make along with the hanging portion. Just make the knots nice and tight so that your string stays nice and tight. If you are using any wool, then at that point, you can just make one knot. That is more than enough. So just see how the hangings are coming off. So like this, yes, there should be four hangings in total. Just nicely cover it up. Nicely make a knot. Make two or three knots if you are using just thread. Okay, so getting the idea, this is how your knotted end should be looking like. This is how your hanging should be looking like by the end. If you are using wool or ribbon, you can just make one knot each. That is more than sufficient. If you are using thread, try to make more than one knot. Otherwise, the thread being thin will fall off the branch. All right, everybody get it done till this step, till the tying of the knots. Everybody just get it done. It's very, very simple. If you don't know how to make a knot or if you are facing problems just tying a knot, you can take the help of an elderly person. You can take the help of an adult and you can tie the knot. We will just wait for everyone to finish up with tying of the knots. Those of you who are already done, you can get ready with your Fevicol, your glue or cello tape, whichever one you have with you, whichever one you plan on using, you can get ready with that. All right, we will just wait for everyone to catch up. Just simple knots are to be made, everyone. Just simple, simple knots, that's all. Good, good. I can see most of you are doing it properly. Very simple, right? Yes. So what will be the next step now? Now after this, we will be just sticking the leaves. We will just be sticking the leaves on these threads or whatever wool, if you have used, then that. Okay, we will just be sticking the leaves with the help of glue or sellotape. Okay? Yes. Okay, we will move on now. I hope everybody has finished with the tying of the threads. For the next step, now just take one leaf, any leaf. It can be a large leaf, a small leaf, any leaf, and a piece of sellotape. And just attach the string to its back like this. See how I'm sticking it? Just simply take that leaf and you can alternate between your large leaf and small leaf, whatever way you want to stick them. If you've taken a large leaf at the bottom of the thread, you can put a small leaf at the top of the thread. Okay, same thread at the top. Now I'm taking a smaller leaf like this. Just put the sellotape. All right, same here now. Same for the others. If you are using a small leaf at the bottom of your thread, then use a larger leaf at the top. Just keep changing. It is completely up to you how you want to decorate it. So just take the string and where we are attaching the sellotape, at the back of the leaf, the white uncolored portion of the leaf is where we are tying the sellotape. Okay, same now for the top portion, then I will be using a big leaf. Keep cutting pieces of sellotape, or if you have glue, just keep sticking it with the glue so that it stays nice and firm. Okay, just attach it nicely. Done. And same for the other leaves. Same for the other leaves. Everybody getting my point? How we are sticking all of these leaves? So same for the third string also. We will apply some sellotape at the back like this and get it done. At the top, we will have a smaller leaf. Just keep cutting pieces of sellotape and just keep attaching them. That's all. Same for the last set also. Getting it, everyone? There shouldn't be any issues. Just four sets of leaves like this. All right, so here you have your wall hanging ready. See how nicely you've got four sets of crinkled fan folded leaves, and you've got it nothing out of but you've got it out of nothing but paper and just a simple branch. That's all. Okay, just quickly complete the pieces, everyone. You can start showing your work. If you've already completed it, you can start showing it. You can start showing your work, all right, if you have completed it. So what did you learn in today's class? In today's class, you learned how to make a wall hanging with nothing but paper and some readily available twig or branch of a tree and also some wool or thread. And apart from that, you learned about the colors of autumn. So what are the colors of autumn that I told you? You were supposed to use red, yellow, orange, and also green and brown were allowed. So these are the colors that are falling into the autumn bracket. So whenever you have to make any piece that is related to autumn, like your scenery or any craft work related to autumn, so always focus on these colors. These are the colors that are characterizing the autumn season. All right? Okay? Very good. I can see some very nice and neat works. So whenever you put all of these efforts, all of your works into submissions, remember you should be submitting them in the proper format. Okay, whatever format is mentioned to you, you should be following them strictly, because when I see some of you just post a photo, that is not the format. Follow the proper guidelines, okay, and just post a photo like that so that your efforts can be recognized and you can come in the top 10 featured artworks of that particular class. Getting my point, everyone? Yes. So all of your beautiful hard works, all of the beautiful creations that you have made, you're definitely going to put them up on the home walls, right? That in the next class, I want to see them all on your walls, hanging on your walls. Yes. And I want to see them in the submissions too. So keep submitting. All of your efforts should not go into vain. I can see so many pretty, nice and neat works. Remember to submit them neatly and take a nice photograph and submit it. All right? Very good. Very good. So I hope everybody enjoyed today's class, right? And I want to see all of your beautiful creations. So don't forget to submit them. Yes. And I hope you will be using these wall hangings and you will be decorating your room with it. Yes. Very good. Very good. All right. So learn something new today. So hope to see all of you soon in another class. Okay. Till then, take care, everyone. All right, we will see you in another class. Bye-bye. Take care.
Hi, everyone. We are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. Then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder. Your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.